are soldiers in the army. We have to fight, also we have to die. We have to hold up the not-staring banners. We have to hold it up until we die. We are soldiers in the army. We have to fight, also we have to die. We have to hold up the not-staring banners. We have to hold it up until we die. We are soldiers.
One more time. one, the last one. Because we need to make a declaration that no other God can take his place. We have to make a declaration that depression, anxiety, or low self-esteem, our finances, at our workplace, whatever problem it is that we're going through, that it cannot take its place this morning. So we're going to lift that up as an offering. And we're going to give him some glory this morning.
Hallelujah.
We're going to declare that no foreign God,
hallelujah,
no foreign God, no other God can take your place this morning, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We give you glory.
Thank you. Then the man who had received one bag of gold came. Master, he said, I knew that you are a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid and went out and hid your gold in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you. His master replied, you wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. Well then, you should have put my money on deposit with the bankers, so that when I returned and I would have received it back with interest. So take a bag of gold from him and give it to the one who has 10 bags. For whoever has will be given more and will have an abundance. Whoever does not have even what they will be taken from them. And throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the word of the Lord.
Greetings, everyone. Greetings. It's a wonderful feeling to see everyone looking so beautiful, knowing that we are made in the image and likeness of God this morning, and we are here well, holy, free, and we can lift up our voices and our hands and just give him some praise in the house. Give him some praise and extend thanks to one for that. We are in the house this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. I just want to say, I love seeing you. You look beautiful down there. Thank you. Greetings to our host pastor. Greetings to Minister Durrant. Greetings to our leaders and musicians. Just give you some sound on the instruments. Just one sound. Amen. And greetings to you, beautiful congregation. I'm Sister Kimoy, and I'm here from the Public Relations Department. I bring you welcome. Welcome to our visitors. Welcome to you there on social media. Welcome to the community. I remember that the week before we acknowledged that we are on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. If you didn't hear me, I said we are on Instagram right now. So I just want to tell you that if you have not subscribed to YouTube, we are there. Just go to 7 miles. Just hop over to YouTube, 7 miles. Church of God of Prophecy. But it's okay, we are up and out there on social media, amen? Alright, so this morning, I'd like to just say welcome to our elders that are joining us today. You know, youth ministry is not all only about your age, and you know, if you feel young in the spirit, you are welcome also, right? So, want to welcome, if there's any guests, first time person here, one time, second time visiting with us, third, I see one hand, could you just do a regular 7 miles style, with this first song, sugar first, after three, one, two, three. That, I need a little, it needs a little more spice to that. Could you just do it one more time? Just stand there because I guess they don't see which direction you're from. So, after three. One, two, three. Mwah. That's a sugar. But don't sit there. We have something to just pour it over a little. So we can give it a syrup now, right? Then it's let it be a little more. That's good enough. One, two, three. Mwah. So the one alone, that's for you. And you won't get diabetes from that. Enjoy the service. I want to just say that we have a lot of things in store for you today. I'm going to invite Lay Minister Clark to just do a presentation for us this morning.
Everybody, at this time, I'll invite Lay Minister or First Lady, Minister Tanya Durrant, to come. As you know, Minister Durrant, she celebrated her birthday this week on the 24th. Minister Durrant, we just want to say we here at 7 Miles, we love you. We appreciate you. It has been a good 1 year. Minister, on behalf of us here at 7 Miles, we would like to give you this small token with love to say happy, happy birthday. And we move on.
God bless you too, Minister. You deserve it. You are a mother to us. You are a guide. You know, she's just the lady of the house that, you know, you can go to. I don't know about you, but she is my mommy. Love you, mommy. Alright. Now, I also invite Sister Cheryl Carr. Where are you in the house this morning? Amen. And just give her a warm welcome as she comes. Just... Lady, you're the lady of the house this morning. We just turn our attention to the lady of the house this morning. Amen. I hope you're paying attention to what she's doing. I hope you're paying attention to what she has. In that container, amen. Get that yes out there. Yes. Come on. Oh my. Yes.
Only one, she Jamaican,
all right.
She, one. $100 for the school week. Today, we are just the
$100.
Alright. You want to? I have a little too loud now. You want to?
I
need it.
We're just giving up for the Agua lady. This test is walking out right now. Walking out in style. If you want to purchase one, she's right outside. She's right outside. $100 right now, right now, right now. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Sister Cheryl.
I now invite the ladies of the White family, two young ladies that will be ministering to us at this moment. Young lady, I'm sorry.
Just come
on
here
and sign
me
in the microphone. Thank you.
Amen.
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 God shall lead them.
Hallelujah. Can somebody praise the Lord?
Yeah.
this time, we'll be doing this chorus, just one run of it. Lord, I'm available to you. After which, our director Kimoy will be coming to pray that our youth will utilize their gifts, their talents, and their abilities, all for the glory of God.
Lord, I'm available to you.
Relationship with you this morning. God, we utilize the gifts, the talents, the abilities that we have, the skills, mighty God, to us for experience the true potential that you have for us, that you have in store for us, mighty God. I declare right now that in this very room, mighty God, over your children, over your young adults, over the youth that are in this place, mighty God, many of them might right now, mighty God, like in the past, Lord Jesus, we used to question ourselves, who are we, why are we here? But mighty God, I say that those questions are no more. Mighty God, we will step into, mighty God, or new and sure to find ourselves as young women and men of God in the house, Lord Jesus. We will start the work here, mighty God, but we will, whenever we step into a room, mighty God, you will reap the Joshua generation that will cause a ripple effect in wherever they go, mighty God. I declare around them, you build a fence of fire, mighty God, that as they step into their new encounter with you, God, they will be guided by your Holy Spirit. Mighty God, even if they don't have any relationship with you, they will grow and they will not be discouraged. I come against discouragement in this house. I come against distraction. I come against discouragement. In the name of Jesus, mighty God, around your young people, mighty God, around them, mighty God, I declare over their minds, hallelujah, hallelujah. I declare over the mind, I come against the mental battles that come and place to distract them, because that's what the enemy uses this time. So us to be swayed away from the true potential. I can stand for right now on this plot of ground, mighty God, I declare that they will not be swayed by anything that the enemy has up his sleeve. We cry for pro-life. Every plot of the enemy in this place, we come against the plan that the adversary protects your young people of this nation. People there on social media, yes, some young persons, that our gifts will come to the forefront, our abilities to worship selflessly will come to the forefront. I declare that our youth will be used, mighty God, for your glory and your glory alone, mighty God. And declare everything that we do, your Holy Spirit, you God, will be
doubt in our young people this morning, that they shall not question who they are. You are made in a unique way because you have so much fundamental in the family of God. You might not be the preacher, but surely you are the teacher. You might not be the one to interpret the tongue, but surely you are the deliverer. You might not be the one to be upfront, but you are the reserve soldier. In the name of Jesus, put you to life. All the young people,
in your precious name I pray, give you thanks and lift you up, God. because I know what I have declared, whatever I've broken, whatever I'm losing, Lord Jesus, it already done. In the end, mighty God, you are awesome, Jesus. You are awesome. Worship. Amen.
According to his power.
as we continue in worship this morning, we now reach a crucial point of our day service. But before our speaker comes, Sister Peter, will be praying for our day speaker.
Hallelujah. As you bow your hands, I just want everybody to just lift their faith this morning as we are praying. Lily of the Valley, God, you are bright as the morning star. You are the fairest of 10,000. God, you are the rose of Sharon. Mighty God, you are able. Even though, God, as we come to you, we come to you, mighty God, knowing that you, God, are able, that you, God, are able to do a mighty move this morning. Even though, God, I put your servant before you. Mighty God, we are just mere humans. But mighty God, once we come to you, God, we can be superhuman, God, as you use us. Even though, God, as I put your servant before you, God, I pray that, God, like a mighty rushing wind, God, that you will just come in and you will infiltrate, mighty God. I pray, God, that you will assign your angels, mighty God, around the four corners of this place, mighty God. I pray that, mighty God, you will really come in, God, and have your way, Jesus. If we are here and you don't show up, God, it makes no sense, God. So we are appealing, mighty God, that you come in, God, and you do a move, God. Breathe on us this morning, mighty God. Whatever the word is, God, you have already predestined it. Whatever the word is, God, even though that as it's about to go forth, I pray, Jesus, that you are already preparing the heart of your people. God, I pray that it will not fall on stony ground, mighty God, but it will reach and pierce the hearts of your people, God. It shall be like a two-edged sword. Mighty God, even though as your servant comes, I pray for strength. Mighty God, I pray for strength, mighty God, that whatever the enemy wants to do, God, whatever his plan is, mighty God, that Jesus, you will be in the midst. God, I pray, God, for a supernatural experience, mighty God, even for the speaker, mighty God, that you will take them, mighty God, into another realm, mighty God. God, I declare, God, that this morning it will not be the same old God, but God, that the word that you have for us, mighty God, that God, it will be sent forth, mighty God. I pray the fire, mighty God, to fall upon your servant, even though that, mighty God, as they take the mic, Jesus, that, mighty God, there will be just an anointing, mighty God, that will come out, mighty God. I pray that, Jesus, whatever it is that your people are going through, mighty God, I pray, God, that this word will be so flexible that God will appear, mighty God, that you will, Jesus, be applied to every situation, mighty God. It will be flexible. God, I pray, Jesus, that the word that you have to go for, mighty God, that, mighty God, it will really have an impact not only on those here, but God, I pray that it will have an impact on those on social media, mighty God. God, I pray for a special touch, mighty God. Even now, Jesus, we open our hearts, mighty God. God, we open our hearts, mighty God. It's not one, God, it's not two, but mighty God, we are all congregation, God, that is coming to your throne room, God, and we're asking you to have your way. God, deliver, set free, mighty God. And I pray for that supernatural experience, God, that you will take us, take our minds here from here, God, and really take us to that heavenly realm, God, that you really have for us, God. I tell you thanks, because I believe in my spirit, God, that this morning something supernatural will happen. God, we declare it, we receive it, mighty God. And we tell you thanks, Jesus. I come against every plan and every darts of the enemy. And as I stand in the gap, mighty God, I declare that, Jesus, you will set up a standard. God, your word declares that when the enemy comes in like a flood, God, you will put up a standard. And even now, God, I pray for your standard, mighty God, over your man servant, mighty God. And I pray, Jesus, that any darts that come, mighty God, it will backfire in the mighty name of Jesus. And that is that your will go forth. Your will be done. And I tell you thanks, mighty God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
We ask you to stand at this point. We welcome our Pastor Samuel Durrant congregation.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody shout a hallelujah. Come on, shout a hallelujah. Come on, shout a hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Our God is worthy to be praised. Our God is God. Come on. Our God is God. All the other gods, they are the works of men. But our God, and I believe he deserves some praise. Come on, he deserves worship. He deserves thanksgiving. Hallelujah. There's a song that we used to sing, what a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Praise the name of Jesus. I must greet the Holy Spirit this morning, who is the head of our lives. Hallelujah. We greet the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of Jesus. I must also greet our ministering body here this morning with us, Minister Tanika Durrant, Lay Minister Sinclair, Lay Minister Mary, Lay Minister Melanie Clark, Lay Minister Baptiste. Bless the name of the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Any more lay ministers? Praise God. I must also greet our youth department, our moderators this morning. Praise the name of the Lord. Put your hands together for the youth of our church. Praise God. Hallelujah. I am praying for the youths of this church, because I believe that the Lord has some work for you. Youths of 7 miles, youths of this region, the Lord has some work put out for you. Are you ready for it? Come on, are you ready for it? Hallelujah. Come on, we need to see some exciting youths. Hallelujah. On the battlefield for the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I must also greet all our visitors who are here this morning. I must greet the young lady here in the front. God bless you. And I must ask our dear lady. Wonderful, wonderful. Can you just shout your name again for me?
Bonfield.
Right. I get to understand that she used to worship, well, she still worship at a church in Clarendon, the Church of God of Prophecy. St. Catherine. Yes. Thanks for the correction. St. Catherine. But she's living in this here and now. So somehow she has good sense. And she sends the Church of God of Prophecy 7 miles. So she wants to make here her stop whenever she's not going to St. Catherine. Can I ask the congregation to put your hands together for her? She's Sister Bonfield. So when you see her, please make her feel welcome. God bless you. God bless you. Visiting friends, God bless you. Any other visitor? Oh yes. A little friend from, oh Lord, stand right here. Praise the name of the Lord. Put your hands together for her. Bless the name of the Lord. I tell you that these young ladies, oh yes, beautiful, beautiful. And my brother, bless you, man. Bless you. Shout your name for me, please. Everton. Bless the name of the Lord. Put your hands together for brother Everton. Praise God. And sister. Adolisa, what an Adolisa, your cousin, what a name, Adolisa. All right, bless the name of the Lord. Thank you so much. Put your hands together for praying this morning. And yes, in what color that again? Oh, burgundy, purplish kind of color. Can you stand up, my dear? Bless the name of the Lord. God bless you. So nice to see you this morning. Praise God. Brethren, I want us to pray for these two ladies for me, and there's another one. I believe that the Lord is working on them. With the other one, you know, said? Yes. Right. I believe that the Lord is working with them, and I want us to pray for them. Since we had our crusade, they are always been coming, and I tell you, trust me, if it wasn't COVID,
would see them more often. And I really want us to welcome them, pray with them, encourage them, because I believe that the move that God has here for 7 miles, they will be a part of it. Amen? Come on, church. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. It's so nice to see everyone. So nice to see. This is Levon Sinclair, your friend. Praise the name of the Lord. So good to see you, my brother. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yeah, man. Things are going through. Yes. Praise God. So nice to see you, my dear elder. God bless you. God bless you. And so nice to see Sister Cunningham again. God bless you, Sister Cunningham, and all you lovely people that are here this morning. Chrissy and Katie. Whoa. Our social media friends. My God. Put your hands together for Chrissy and Katie. Oh, my God. I tell you that these two young ladies, I want us to pray for them. You know, every platform that we are on for 7 miles, they are here so much. I tell you, they participated so well. My God, God bless them. God bless them. Mommy Wilson, the Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. Praise the name of the Lord. Sister O'Connor and Brother O'Connor, God bless you. Praise the name of the Lord. And we want to also give a shout out to, there are some friends on social media who have been joining us week after week. And I tell you that there is one lady, I must say, she's a member of this church. And she's always praying for us and joining us on social media. Sister Joy Bell and Sister Anderson. Praise the name of the Lord. Sister Anderson, Sister Joy Bell, may the Lord bless you. And we continue to pray for you. Thank you for joining us. And let me tell you, this lady has been blessing the church. And I pray that God will continue to pour out in her life. Hallelujah. Many of these instruments that we have, these equipments that we have, she sent them. She said she's the one that sent them. The mixer board that you hear us coming through. A few of the mics, she has been blessing this church. Can you just throw her some sugar or just put your hands together for her on social media? God bless you, Sister Joy Bell, Sister Anderson, Sister Cynthia Campbell. We bless the Lord for you, my dear sister. Sister Lorraine Hewitt, God bless you. Sister Kimberly Batiste, is it Kimberly Batiste? Yeah, sorry if I mess up your name, but you may talk. God bless you. God bless you. Sister Arlene Barrett, bless the name of the Lord. And Joan Buckner, yes, praise the name of the Lord. These are some people that have been following us week after week, week after week. I tell the church, hallelujah. I just feel like we just need to stretch our hands right now, and we're going to pray for them. We're going to pray that God will touch them, and we're going to pray that whatever they need of the Lord, that God will increase them. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We bless you, because there is just none like unto you. The heavens declare your glory. The firmament show it. Your handiworks. Father, we lift up right now, oh God, your people, Lord God, in social media, Lord Jesus, on media feed right now. We pray in the name of Jesus, God. We lift up Sister, oh God, Anderson before you right now. We pray that God will continue to fill her barns. You'll continue to bless her, God. Lift her up, protect her, God. Surround her with your blessing. We pray, God, for Sister Cynthia Campbell. Oh God, we pray your blessing to be upon her, and that you continue to establish her. Lord, we pray for Lorraine, you with God. You continue to pour out in her in the name of Jesus. Sister Kimberly Batiste, Lord God, we lift her up before you. We pray that your anointing will continue to, oh God, pour out in her life, and your spirit and your presence, God, will continue to overtake her. Your blessing will continue to overtake her. We pray for Arlene Barrett, Lord God, will continue, Jesus, to lift her up. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, Father, we pray that your blessing and your presence will continue to be their real reward, and God, you'll continue to lead them through their wilderness. You'll continue, God, to uphold them, bless them, God. Father, those who we fail to call this morning, Jesus, we ask that you'll bless them even now. We pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that you'll visit their homes right now, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that whatever, God, they are going through at this time, we will be met in Jesus' name. I pray, God, if it's financial struggle, I pray in the name of Jesus that God will make a way. If it's sickness, God, we declare healing right now over your bodies in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. If there's family problem, God, in the name of Jesus, we pray that, God, you will solve the problem, God, because you are a great problem solver. We pray in the name of Jesus that your anointed power will bless and rest upon them. Protect them, God, guide them, give them strength as they go by. We pray that, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, as they walk, God, they will crush the enemy's head, and God, they will know that, God, they are the head and not the tail, and they are above and not beneath, and that, God, they are blessed in the city, they are blessed in the field, they are blessed in their going out, they are blessed in their coming in the name of Jesus. We declare blessing, we declare prosperity, we declare, we declare, we declare, we declare in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, that your anointing power will break every yoke and let your will be done. Hallelujah. We pray, God, for Anne Marie. Oh, hallelujah. For Marie Allen, in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, for Vanessa Allen, in the name of Jesus. Touch them right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you thanks, God. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you all the honor. Somebody shout a praise to the Lord this morning. Somebody shout a praise to the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Our God is awesome. Hallelujah. Come on. I believe that God deserves some praise. He deserves some worship. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, somebody. Come on. Come on. Come on. Open your mouth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And begin to give him praise. Begin to give him praise. Begin to give him praise. Let everything that I press, hallelujah, give the Lord praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, praise him. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same. Our God is worthy to be exalted. Our God is God, hallelujah. All over this world, hallelujah. Jehovah reigns, Jehovah rules, Jehovah is the King of Kings. Come on, somebody praise him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Open up. spirit to be open this morning. I command your worship channel to be open. In the name of Jesus. No more blockage. In the name of Jesus. Because this house is the house of God. And this is the house of praise. This is the house of worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the house of the living God. Come on. Come on. Can somebody praise God with me? Can somebody agree with me? Can somebody agree with me? Any spirit that is not of God, we fall in the name of Jesus. We are resting in the name of Jesus. We cut off your head in the name of Jesus. Come on. Hallelujah. We struck for you. On the feet in the name of Jesus. We say you are defeated. In the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody worship him. My God deserve every praise. My God deserve every worship. Oh, hallelujah. I wish that some of us would be like this. Oh my God, we live like this, Joshua. When did the Joshua and his sister be able to sing? Then they watched the field. Oh, glory to God. Little Joshua, stand up with me, little Joshua. And your little sister, come on. Hallelujah. Come on. Worship God with me. Worship God with me, little Joshua. Worship my God, come on. This is what God wants. Yes, little Joshua, my God. Hallelujah. Praise him. I'm praying for our dancers because I see God have a touch. Oh, hallelujah. I see a touch of God. I'm one of the dancers. Oh, my God. Jesus, I'm worship. So please have a chance on you. It's not this, it's not you, run on you. Oh, God. Because those are the actions. So please have a chance. Hold up the text. So take it by the right. Come on, church. Come on, church. Hey, hey, hey. There's a song that we used to sing. If you don't want to praise him. If you don't want to praise him. Don't enter me. If you don't want to praise him. You can't stop it on my way. You can't set up in my way. Because I mean, you will come for prayer. You come for prayer, the one who creates the heavens and the earth. Oh, glory to God. I come to worship the one that says, let's hear it. Jesus, I come to. You can't stop this. Satan can't stop this. In demon, my God, I wish I had some people to worship with me. Come on, come on, come on. I wish I had some people to agree with me. The devil can't stop this. No witchcraft can't stop this. No, oh God, no woman can't stop this. No God of mine can't stop this. Come on, let the praise of God. I've got to come for worship. I've got to come for praise. Oh, hallelujah. And if it can't sing, never shout. And if it can't preach, never dance. Never look to sight. And never. Jesus has mercy. Oh, glory to God. Somebody shout, hallelujah. The reason that I am on this morning, I am going somewhere because I believe that 7 miles, your shifting moment is coming. I believe that, let me tell you what I see in the spirit. I see God is stretching north towards 7 miles, but 7 miles need to stretch up because when God comes, forgive our wife, glory to God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I believe that when God start to pull 7 miles, when God stretched out and 7 miles stretch up, come on, and God, my God, God begins to pull, God begins to take you over, God begins to take you over, you're gonna go over, you're gonna go over. neighbor, you're going over. And you're going over in style. Jesus have mercy. You're going over in style. Father, we pray this morning that your will be done. Your name be exalted and you be praised. I'm excited about you, Jesus, and what you will be doing. Praise the name of Jesus. I want to draw your attention to the book of Numbers, chapter 13. Praise God. It's a long chapter, but we're going to read it. Praise the name of Jesus. It says, and the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, send thou men, that they may research the land of Canaan, which I give unto the children of Israel. For every tribe of their father shall ye send a man, every one a ruler among them. And Moses, by the commandment of the Lord, sent them forth of the wilderness of Paran. All those men were head of the children of Israel. I found somebody's name in the Bible. When I was touching this chapter, you will hear. And these were the names of the tribe of Reuben. Shemaha. You know, help me pronounce some of them names, man. Praise God. The son of Zakor. Of the tribe of Simeon. Shapha, the son of Hori. Of the tribe of Judah. Caleb, the son of Jephunneh. Of the tribe of Issachar. Egan, the son of Joseph. Of the tribe of Ephraim. Who you see here? Praise the name of the God. Of the tribe of Ephraim, Oshe, the son of Nun. Soon come to that. Of the tribe of Benjamin, Palti, the son of Raphu. Of the tribe of Zebulun, Gadiel, the son of Sodai. Of the tribe of Joseph, name of the tribe of Manasseh. Remember that Manasseh, the son of Joseph, and Ephraim, the son of Joseph, they too got, they were also named among the tribe of Israel, because two of his sons did err and they did not get the blessing. So they were the ones who came into that position. Manasseh and Ephraim, praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Of the tribe of Dan, Amiel, the son of Gemila, something like that. And the tribe of Asher, Sephor, the son of Micah. Of the tribe of Naphtali, Nabi, the son of Vissi. Of the tribe of God, Guriel, the son of Mashi. These are the names of the men which Moses sent to spy out the land. And Moses called Oshe, the son of Nun. Let me just pause here. The same Oshe is Jeshua. His name was Jeshua. And then it was changed to Oshe and then to Joshua. So right there, the name Oshe is the son of Oshe, of Nun, which is Joshua. Also, something interesting about the name of Oshe or Joshua, it means God is our salvation. Our God saves. So Sister Oshie, your name be. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody worship the Lord with me. Thank you, Jesus. And Moses sent them to spy out the land of Canaan and said unto them, get you up this way, southward, and go up into the mountain and see the land which is. And the people that dwell therein, whether they be strong or weak,
few or many, and what the land is that they dwell in, whether it is good or bad, and what city they be, the tent or a stronghold, and what the land is, whether it be fat or lean, whether it be good courage, sorry, good daring, sorry, or not. Be of good courage and bring the fruit of the land. No, the time was the time of the first ripe grape. So they went up and searched the land from the wilderness of Sin unto Rehob, as the men come to Hamath, and they ascended by the south and came unto Hebron. Sorry, one second. Please, of God. I was just kidding with that one still. The advertisement. Praise God. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. But I still need it. Again, praise the name of God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Where was I? Hallelujah. So they went up, you know, past that, right? And they ascended to the south and came unto Hebron, where Ahiman, Shisha, I'm not going to go with some of the name, you know, and Talma, but if I call it right, I didn't see one. And the children of Anak, where now Hebron was built 7 years before Zoan in Egypt. And they came unto the brook of Eshcol, and cut down from thence a branch with one cluster of grain, and they peered it between two of the stars, and they brought of the pomegranates and of the figs. The place was called the brook Eshcol because of the cluster of grain which the children of Israel cut down from thence. And they returned and searched of the land after 40 days. Listen, 40 days. And they went and came unto Moses and unto Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them and unto the congregation, and showed up the fruit of the land. And they told and said, we came unto the land whither thou sentest us, and surely, Jesus have mercy, it bloweth milk and honey, and this is the fruit of it. Nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the city are walled and very great, and moreover, we saw great of Anak there, great children of Anak there. The Amalekite, I want you to take note of the Amalekite, hallelujah, dwell in the land of the south of the Hittite and the Jebusite, and the Amorites dwell in the mountains of Canaan, the Canaanites, and dwell by the sea and by the coast of Jordan, and Caleb, my God, Jesus, good spy. Good spot. And Caleb still the people and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome. My God. Somebody say, I'm well able. Come on, somebody say, I am well able. Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah. But the men went up with him and said, the men that went up with him said, we do not able to go against the people, for they are stronger than we, and they brought up an evil. Jesus have mercy. There are some people who are among us, but they are not with us. Jesus have mercy. There are some people that are among us, but they are not with us. Come on, somebody. We're going to see what takes place here. Hallelujah. And they brought up an evil report of the land which the Lord had shared, which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it is
a land that eateth up inhabitants thereof, and all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. My God, Jesus, they never know. Hallelujah. And there we saw giants, the son of Anna, which came of the giant, and we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so were we in their sight. Let me stop there. Evil report. Father, we ask that you have your way on your word this morning. We pray that, God, you will be exalted above your word, Jesus. And Lord God, you will, hallelujah, open the windows of heaven and pour out in us and in our spirit your will, your power, not our will, but your will. And Father, we ask you right now that your blessing will be upon us and upon your word, in Jesus' name. As we have read, we have some people among us that are living among us, but there is a situation that faces them that they themselves don't even understand. And because, as a result of that, they continue to give false report. They continue to give wrong report. Having observed life, life is a warfare. From the day you were born, sister of men, lady sister of men, you are fighting. Life is a warfare. But there's two kinds of war that exist in life. There's a spiritual warfare, and there's a natural warfare. Sometimes people are caught up between. Some people are caught in one. Because the warfare, the natural warfare of life, you have to fight for survival. They have a saying that says only the fittest of the fittest will survive, or only the strong will survive. But there is another twist to it. Hallelujah. But we just need to tap into the next realm, because we just facing the natural realm. And when we are overcome and bewildered by the natural realm, we lose hope. In life, you have to battle with sickness. In life, you have to battle with death. In life, you have to battle with pain. In life, you have to battle with the bills to pay. In life, you have to battle with your own self. Yes. Jesus of mercy. It is a warfare that you are in. But Jesus have mercy. But if you look at it from the physical side, you will be defeated. You will only tell yourself that I am just here for a purpose, for a reason, and that's it. From birth to death, and that's it. But when you're looking at it from a spiritual perspective, you realize that, listen, there is more to life than what I'm seeing. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. There is more to what I'm experiencing. It cannot be so. It cannot be just like this. It cannot be that I'm just fighting. I'm not getting. Oh my God, my God. I wish I had somebody, hallelujah, who would praise God in this. That is not just so. I have a reason to fight. The topic I'm looking at this morning, and so well, the dancers, you danced to that tune this morning. I believe that everything that is being done this morning was spiritually lined up. That warfare kind of dancing. I don't remember the song that they were. The battle is not you, Jesus of mercy. Come on, church. I want to reassure you this morning. I want to confirm in the spirit this morning that the
you are in is not yours. Jesus, have mercy. Are we somebody? We get it. Hallelujah. The battle is not yours. If you're fighting against the sickness in your body, the battle is not yours. If you're fighting against problems at work, the battle is not yours. If you're fighting against the natural crisis, the battle is not yours. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You need to know that you have somebody. As the Son of Jesus said, I've got somebody with me to share my heavy load. I feel His presence near me. Every day when sorrow overtakes me, along life's weary road, I've got, come on, church, have you got somebody? Do you have somebody? Can you lift up a name? Can you lift up His name? Can you lift up His name? I've got somebody with me. The battle is not yours. What you're going through, my sister, the battle is not yours. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. What you're going through, sister, see clear. It is not yours. The battle is not yours. Oh, glory to God. Oh, my God. There's a son that said, turn it over. Oh, hallelujah. I wish I had somebody this morning. Oh, my God, sister, where is good? Just turn it over. Just turn it over. Turn it over to the demon. Turn it over to the demon kids. The men brought back an evil report. The men went and spied on the land. Now, this was a command. I want you to watch what it says from verse 1. This was a command that was given by God. It wasn't Moses that came and said, I saw a piece of land. I'm in love with steel. Me love how it look. I'm a piece of one conquer and get that piece of land. When God brought the children out of Israel, out of Israel, out of Egypt, the Lord, hallelujah, brought them into the wilderness. And when they came over into the wilderness, then, oh my God, God already have a plan. Jesus have mercy. I want to tell somebody this morning that God already have a master plan for your situation. Oh, glory to God. God already made a way out of your situation. Oh, glory. You're not just fighting like that. You're not just crossing over like that. Oh, glory to God. There is something more. There is something more. There is something more. Something more is coming. These men, it was 12 of them from every tribe. The Bible tells us that God told Moses, get each man from each tribe, preferably the leader of the tribe. Hallelujah. Because it must be something that you are doing while you are a leader. Hallelujah. So God said, I'm sending out, oh my God, hallelujah, 12 of them. So call them. So the 12 came. And Moses gave them the instruction that the Lord said that you are to go and spy out the land. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Am I talking to somebody here this morning? That God tells you to do something. Hallelujah. But you're procrastinating. Oh, glory. But it's time for you to spy out. You're not. If I'm talking to somebody in social media or on social media this morning, the time has come for you to spy out. You're not. If God says it, then He's gonna make a lot of mercy. He's gonna make a way out of it. So don't worry. When God gave you the instruction, just follow the instruction. But spy out your land. 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 Can I tell somebody this morning? But spy out your land. In the name of Jesus. that God sent 12. And maybe there's a reason that he sent 12. When the men came back from the land that they went and spied, they brought back a report. But I believe that what happened on the way, they were lazy to fight. They had doubt. Fear took hold of them. And so they brought back a bad report, evil report from the flesh. They had conspired against themselves, collude among themselves, and said, listen, let us tell Moses that the land that we went and spied, it has a wall around. It is a wall. We can't, it is fortified. The wall that we see, the land that we see among us, it will consume everything that comes in its sight. Meaning that a pure warrior down there. So, they started the defeating process in their mind. Jesus have mercy. But I believe that where they were going through. Now watch this now. You see how the devil is alive. The same men that brought back the bad report, they bear evidence that the land, Jesus have mercy, that the land is luscious, the land is prosperous, the land is good, because they brought back a cluster of grapes. You know how grapes stay. My wife grapes here all the way, don't it? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, ladies know how grapes stay. You can carry any amount of grapes. But this time, it was a big difference. The grapes that they brought back could not be carried by one man. It could not be carried in a bag. Lord of mercy, they had to bear it on the shoulder of two men. What I'm saying to us, church, is that God has some blessing in store for you. That if you cannot see it with your natural eyes, you're going to lose it. Because you have some people that are going to bring some false report. But the Bible tells us that the men decided that we are going to tell Moses and the congregation. It don't make no sense to God. It don't make no sense to war with them people. We are already defeated. The blood of Jesus. Come on, church. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us that we are more than conquerors through him that loves us. But I believe that while they were conspiring, and while they were consulting, and while they were bringing up the false report, and using all kinds of examples, Joshua, oh hallelujah, Oshay and Caleb was there walking and saying, hallelujah. And then they riled up the bad report. When they reached the camp, they start to scare everybody. They start, hallelujah, the campaign. Every man, hallelujah, 10. Amen. 10 out of the 12. 10 from the 12 brought back bad report. More than 80%. Can you imagine? If God did not send the 12, if God did not send the 12, what would have happened? Let me tell you something. What the Lord is saying to me right now. That when God takes you out of certain situations,
or the place that you're at right now, presently in your life. This is what I'm hearing from the Lord. It's not a place for you to dwell. I don't know who this is for, but I'm hearing from the Spirit of God that when the Lord bring you out and place you somewhere, it is not for you to take residence, because the boundaries of the Lord is more than where you are seen. Hallelujah. The Lord goes beyond your eyesight. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. There is more for you to see. Come on, somebody. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but there's more for you to see. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. It is not like your bedroom that you lock up, and when you look, you see wall to the left, wall to the right, wall to the north, wall to the south. But when God has opened the door, you shall look, and where your eyes approach, it shall be yours. Come on, somebody, I say to you, look within the spirit, look within the spiritual realm, because where you are. But you shall not quit. The Bible tells us that when they scare the people in the next chapter, the people start to mourn. They start to bawl. They say, Moses, why you never leave with me in Egypt, left with them? Why you bring me out here in the wilderness for the people that to come and kill us? When, oh Jesus, have mercy. It's like the people are saying, we would have been better off dying in Egypt than where we are at. Let me tell you the truth. And I'm not bashing anyone. I want us to understand, church, that the reason that some people are living in sin is that they cannot see the promised land. They cannot see the greater things that are ahead of them. You think it's just mere flesh? How should I put it? I'm using myself as an example. If I follow my flesh, I will dwell in sin and eat and become a slave to sin. What sin does is limit your ability to see in the spiritual. It limits your life. Sin closed you, locked you, and shut you down. Sin wanted to dwell in Egypt, where you are bound by the fear of it. The fear of your life. The things that are depressing you. It doesn't matter how much money as the people have. They are still living under depression. Because there is something that is missing. And you have a certain set of people that even if, my sister, they have a piece of bread, once they have Jesus, they are, my God, my God. So, the Bible tells us that God said to them, that Joshua and Caleb stood up and said, listen, false report, false alarm, none of us up. Jesus have mercy, it takes two. That is why the Bible said that when two are three. Come on, church. Once we agree, we just want to. Hallelujah. I don't want to approach Jesus of mercy. Hallelujah. We just want to approach Jesus of mercy. Hallelujah. Just two of us need to agree in the spirit. Oh my God, my God. And things can change. Things must change. Things have to change. The Bible tells us that Joshua came in. Quiet the crowd. Say, you men are your liars. You are wicked. They said, Moses, and let me tell you this. Joshua was Moses' right hand. Caleb was next in line. So the two men that are close to the servant of God was seeing something else. Not the men that just want something. They just in your midst. Because they just did it because they did it. Yeah. You have some people like that, you know. Them just go with the crowd. Them just go with the crowd. But you need some people who will see in the spirit. And these two men, they begin to see in the spirit. And they said, listen to me. Yes, Moses. Even if the report with them said, go so. And it's the love with Caleb and Joshua. The man that said, even if they're not convinced, you know, say, are we not convinced, you know, over what their report says? But if God says so, she'll come to the most Santa. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Just what Caleb said, if God sends us, we shall go. Oh, my God, my God. It doesn't matter what man says, but in what God says, whose report will you believe? Who's the porter? Will you believe? If God said yes, if Jesus of mercy, come on somebody, praise God. Come on somebody, worship him. Come on somebody, lift him up. Oh God, hallelujah. If God said it, that sentence it. I tell somebody, did I give you a topic this morning? Hallelujah. The topic I'm looking at is, we are well able to overcome it. Come on, church. We are well able to overcome it. I started out by saying to us that when we start life, we have to hit the ground running because life is a warfare. Life is a source of stuff. But one thing I get to understand, sister, lay minister, hallelujah. One thing I get to understand, when you come in this life, just make sure that you cling on to Jesus, my sister. Come on, get Jesus with you. Oh, hallelujah. Because of social distance, we can't grab some people, so you have to stand by. Just make sure you grab on to Jesus when you're in this life. Oh, glory to God. The Bible, the Son said, I've got somebody with me to share by the Lord. Make sure that when you come into this life, you are Jesus. Sister Debbie, some people are going to give you some false report. My sister, people are going to give you some false response. But if God sent you, have no fear. If God sends you, have no fear. Manager, hallelujah. Sister Sherry, if God sent you, have no fear. Jesus of mercy, I wish I'm talking to somebody. Hallelujah. If God sent you, Sister Williamson, have no fear. Oh, glory to God. Because God has a reason that he sent you. Oh, hallelujah. You might look like a wimp. You may not look like a fighter. You may not look like a girl. We in a short order. But let me tell you something. Yes, get ready, because Sister Oche, she's gonna be a mighty victory. Somebody shout, hallelujah.
Amen.
even if them report is true, 100% true, and God said, we be God. Come on, church, you don't get it. You don't get it. Even if, hallelujah, they say that we look like grasshopper in them sight, and we don't look like nobody in them sight. If God said the grasshopper, he going to do damage. Mighty God, hallelujah, hallelujah. It doesn't matter how the devil sees you. When God said you, you're gonna create damage. You're gonna create damage. We are the people that are ready to do some damage. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Sister Christina, are you ready to do some damage? Come on, we are the people that are ready to do some damage. If God said it, you're gonna conquer. We don't listen to what man says. When man in the flesh, man say anything. But when man is in the spirit, they will see the will of God. And we have some people who are operating in the flesh that can only see the things of the flesh. They only consult to tear down and to create physical damage and bring mental oppression and depression. Jesus have mercy. I wonder if somebody hears what I'm saying. Because you have some people in life, they are not constructive to what God is doing. They are not in line with what God is doing. Their main purpose is to tear down. Because, they, my God, when they are living in the flesh, they cannot see the things of the Spirit. Amen. You know, when I go get my amen. But it's time for some of us to come out of the flesh. Come on. Shake out the flesh. Jesus have mercy. Come on, somebody, you need to shake off the flesh. If you are in the flesh, you cannot please God. That was dead in biblical time. In order for the men to conquer, they had to fight. Sister Lakimi, God told them, go and spy out the land. Because I am going to give you the land. That's the reason that God says you're the spy. It doesn't matter what they name. They name them out here. The Amalekites. The devil is a liar and he's a wicked. Watch this, church. When Israel came out of the bondage of Egypt, the first war that they fought was with the Amalekites. The first war that they fought was with the Amalekites. The Bible tells us that when Moses is in Exodus, smoothed, my God. Exodus chapter 20, 20, 19, they're about in Exodus, but in the teens or so. But the Bible tells us that when Moses sent them to war, the day was fast ending. The Bible said that Moses lifted up his hand. And when he lifted his hand, Israel prevailed. But when his hands got weary, the Amalekites prevailed. I love Joshua. When Joshua did, Jesus have mercy. We love that you there. Lord of mercy. Joshua saw what was happening. And Joshua, Lord, let me tell you something. When you are fighting, you need to observe. Be observant. Lord of mercy. The Bible said that every time Moses lift up the man, Israel start to win. But every time the hand of Moses start to go down, Lord of mercy, the Amalekites were all over the Israelites and they were winning. But Joshua said, come here and we see something that no man has seen. Let me go and bear of Moses. Lord of mercy, do we have some people inside here who will bear of Moses? Who will bear of Moses? Lift up. Sometimes you need a little strength. You need an additional strength. Hallelujah. God can use anybody to give you strength. Because you have some people who come to pull you down. You have some people who come to burn you down. But let me tell you something. If you have Joshua on your side, and if you have Caleb on your side, it is alright. They shall bear up your hand that you win the war. Come on, somebody. We come to conquer. We shall overcome. We are more than able to overcome this. Tell your neighbor, we are more than able to overcome this. Hallelujah. That's my topic this morning. If it is sickness that is in your body, you are more than able to overcome it. If it is sickness that is in your family, you are more than able to overcome it. If there is financial difficulties, you are more than able. Come on, somebody. Am I talking? It is a hope you want. You are more than able to overcome it. Oh, glory to God. If you need a good doctor's report, you are more than able to overcome it. Because I've got the Lord on my side. Jesus is on my side. I'm fighting not for victory, but I'm fighting in victory. I'm fighting from a standpoint because I've seen my victory. I'm going to see my victory. Come on, somebody. I'm going to see my victory. Oh, my God. It might not be today, but I see my victory. It might not be tomorrow, but I see my victory. My victory is coming. Can I talk to somebody? Can I preach to somebody? Your victory is coming. You can't see it. You see it for the report. You hear it for the report. The false news. But I want to tell somebody something. That was then. False report keeps you quiet. False report steals your breath. False report steals your joy in the Lord. False report muzzle you from praising God. You come to church, you cannot worship. False report. Let me tell you something, Jesus. I'm speaking in the spirit, and if you don't like it, talk to God. False report. I've allowed you to be bound. Hallelujah. It's not what God says, but it's what your mind is saying. It's what the flesh is saying. If you don't like what I'm saying, and if you don't believe what I'm saying, talk to God about it. But something has to change. If, oh my God, if the 10 persons are the 10 men brought back the false report, if Joshua and Caleb are taken aside, I keep their mouth shut, my God, what a devastation
Cannot. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, somebody praise God. Somebody worship God. Come on. There's something that I observe when the wildebeest, I love to watch those lion documentaries, those animal documentaries. I love to watch them. I don't know, but I would watch them and I could bring myself from watching them. There's something about the wildebeest that I observe. They do their breathing in terms of reproducing at a particular season of the year, time of the year. I think it's somewhere between February to April, thereabout. And when they do their, when their young have been born, in less than an hour, that young wildebeest have to be on its legs running. The reason for this is that they are living in an environment. It's either you keep running or be killed. Jesus have mercy. They were surrounded by the hyenas, the lions, the leopard, the tigers, and the wild dogs, all different kinds of predators they are exposed to. So as soon as that baby jumped out of the mother's womb, the mother licked the side and the limbs to strengthen the young. Within an hour, it's amazing. Normally when you look at a dog puppy would take like 3 weeks to start moving strong. Eyes start open. The lions are the cats, meaning in the same kind of time frame. And there are some other animals that, but these animals, they are praised in the sense of they are ready to be eaten. They are seen as meat, as delicious food. So when the lions sees the mother wildebeest have the young, quickly run it down, devour it. But sometimes I watch the wildebeest as she carefully mops are surrounding. And look, we are gonna have my young because the time has come. She ensured she went into the dry of the grass. And she hid herself among. And sometimes, let me tell you, sometimes these animals, they are so sensitive. Whenever they know that another animal is about to have a young, they would correct and build a fortress around and hide that young in the midst, and so that young will be able to get some strength, hallelujah, within an hour. And by the time that hour comes, hallelujah, that wildebeest can run at least 20 miles per hour, hallelujah. He's on that fine length, and he just keep moving, because if I don't run, hallelujah, here comes the enemy. He's behind me. The lions are there. The tigers are there. So I have to keep running. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I cannot stay where I'm at. So I'm saying to you, hallelujah, that when God moves into one position, don't get comfortable. You've got to keep running, because the devil is out there, and he's just waiting for you to get comfortable. But if you know what I know, hallelujah, you got to keep running. Come on, church. You got to keep running. Keep running, church. Keep running, church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Take it home here. Because we are living in a time and in a day and age where things are different. The children of Israel, they fought with sword, they fought with daggers, they fought with weapons. Oh, hallelujah. They fought with spears and all kinds of weapons, physical weapons. But you see, the physical weapon is because they are seen from a physical perspective. Hallelujah. They use the physical weapon to kill or to conquer their enemies. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody pray for me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You see, the physical weapon can only destroy the flesh. Jesus have mercy. I wish I had some worshipers inside here with me. Some people are ready to give God praise. Some people are ready to give God worship. Some things have to change. Some things must change. The way we do things have to change. Hallelujah. Lay Minister Clark, the way we do things must change. Hallelujah. Sister Tamara, the way we do things must change. We cannot allow the devil to know our move. Every minute, hallelujah, every second, the devil is all over us. He knows our every move. You've got to be spontaneous. You've got to be creative. You've got to come with different style, different tactics. Come on, church. If you cannot stay. The children of Israel fought in the flesh to conquer the physical land. Because that land was given to Abraham. When the Lord told Abraham in Genesis 12 to 13, thereabout, when the Lord told him to leave his father's house, Tohak, leave your father, Yah, the father worship idol. Let I will carry you to a land. Me, I will carry. When God say you are to go, get up and go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord said, the Bible said Moses obeyed, and when Moses went, Abraham went, and Abraham, when God said, yes, you reach. Now lift up your eyes and look all around me. When he look, lands fertile, fat, luscious. God says, everything in your eyesight and beyond this point is yours. So when the Amalekite, come on, when the Jebusites, they are doing there. When the Hittites are doing there, what they are doing there, it's not their place. It's not their place. When the older man are doing in your father business, in your property, in your place, when the false are pagan worshippers are doing in the position that God has given to you. What are they doing there? I'm saying to you, if you don't fight for it, you will lose it. But I want us to zero in this moment on a particular scripture. I believe I'm going to close with this. But I want us, church, to understand. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Have your way, Jesus. I want us to understand, church, that though we walk in the flesh, we do not wage war against the flesh. We don't war against the flesh. That was Joshua's days. When he war in the flesh, when he conquered the Hittites, when he conquered the Jebusites, when he conquered the Amalekites. But we are in a different dispensation. We are in a different time where we don't need sword, where we don't need weapons, we don't need physical.
physical weapons. The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 3, it says, hallelujah, my God, though we war, hallelujah, we walk in the flesh, we do not, come on somebody, my God, I think I've lost it here, but we don't rage war in the flesh. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 3. It says, "For we, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh." Hallelujah. For the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. Let me pause just a minute and take us back, because I want the church to understand that our warfare weapons, they are not, oh hallelujah, they are not mundane. They are our worshiping. Come on, somebody, it's time for you to start taking over and start to step out of where you are. Hallelujah, hallelujah. This coming to church and sitting down, hallelujah, it cannot work. Let me tell you something. I'm getting somewhere in my message. I know I'm stirring up some things, but let me tell you something. There is, hallelujah, a certain amount of anointing when you stand. Hallelujah. There's a certain amount of anointing when you begin to dance in the spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. There's a certain amount of anointing when you begin to shout. When you begin to shout. The hallelujah. You break some heavy magic. You break the metal head. When you come to church, you come to rejoice. Oh, glory to God. Even sickness is rocking your body. Rejoice. The Bible says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. I'm not going to be down. And I know the devil to have it over me. I'm going to get up. I'm going to dance. I'm going to sing. I'm going to jump. I'm going to make some moves. I'm going to war in the spirit. Because my weapon, they are not God. They are not good. They are mighty. Through God. Put it down. Come on, church. When a church is too quiet, the devil gets the upper hand. The Bible says in Psalm 100, make a joyful. It says, I will enter in his gates. Come on. With the spirit in my heart. Heavier. are most heavy. You come to church, you shake up. Come on, church. What I'm saying, your victory is in your dance. There's a certain kind of dance that you get that the enemy doesn't like. Come on, church. Hallelujah. When you begin to move, when you begin to stop your feet, when you begin to wave your hands, or a soldier cannot march sitting up. You cannot march sitting up. We are the children of God. Hallelujah. We need to begin to trample the enemy. There are many, oh God, scenarios in the Bible that tells us about it. When Joshua was about to capture Jericho, God telling him, get down, begin to march around the walls of Jericho. Here comes Joshua and the army around the walls of Jericho. Come on, church. When we come into the house of God, there's a time when we got to march. I still see some people sitting up. Hallelujah. I want some people, if you believe with me, if you believe with me, come on. There's a time when you need to just march, march. Come on, children of God. We got to march. We are the one over there. We are going to talk in the name of Jesus. We are going up. We are going up. We are on the top. Come on. March. Come on. You want to step your feet to the God. Step those feet. Just take your position. Hallelujah. As Christians, we need to start conditioning our mind to take our position. Hallelujah. Because why do you think that the children of Israel take their position? Because they were about to conquer. Come on. If there's a, oh God, is there somebody inside you? You feel that you're about to conquer. Begin to march into the territory. Come on. Come on. Begin to march in the territory. March. Oh God. There's some situations at your home. Begin to march. Begin to march. Requires the moving of hands. Oh, glory to God. Because when you begin to move your hands in the heavenlies, in the spirit, you are putting down the prince of Persia. Come on. Come on. You're putting down some demonic forces. My God. Help me. Come on. Begin to worship. Begin to worship. Daniel begins to press.
bubbling. You don't see it yet. But stay fresh. Stay fresh. Stay fresh. Stay fresh. 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 Bubbling.
Thank you.
on well, Lord. Because if a boy be dead, God forbid, them are gonna kill some. But because we know, we don't fight against flesh and blood. Some demon must die. Phil, come on. Full of yourself with the anointing of God. With the spirit of God. With the power of God. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there someone? Hallelujah. There is a show.
Hallelujah.
When you show, there are some demons in the enemy.
Hallelujah.
There are some demons that are in certain segments of heaven. The same one that helped Daniel. Hallelujah. It's blessing. The lady is blessing. But even though it delayed, it wasn't denied. But the Bible tells us that Daniel continued to pray. Daniel, come on, church. I believe that God is calling us into a warfare.
Hallelujah.
Me serve God have mercy. No offense. No offense. But if you feel like you want to go to floor, glory to God. If you feel like you want to go to floor, we're going to tell you something. There's a word of Christ right here. Do that! Somebody want to shout the hallelujah. Somebody want to shout the hallelujah. Thank God for the land that you have not conquered yet. Thank God.